Ed, come and have a look what I've got for you.
Hello, mate.
Wow.
A 1985 Maserati BiTurbo two-door proper car.
Oh, mate, this is fantastic. Thing is, this isn't the fuel injection one, is it?
No, this is the carburetor one. Get to the engine in a minute. Just savour the rest of the car. Look at that interior.
Oh, look at that. Look at that Italian luxury. That is fantastic. I'm guessing everything works. So what's the catch?
Why is there always a little bit of resistance every time I bring in a car thinking that there's something wrong? You might be charged when you find just how good this car actually is. You like it?
Well, yeah, I do. The bodywork's in pretty good nick. I mean, there's a little ding on the front down there and stuff. And so that has to be sorted.
Well,
what's with the suspension?
Shocks, you mean?
Have you bought us a BiTurbo without a BiTurbo?
Oh, I'm so excited to tell you that I bought a Maserati BiTurbo that's a little bit better than a Maserati BiTurbo. I think you're going to be amped when you get under the bonnet of this car.
Check that out. That is fantastic. This is the first electric car we've ever had in the workshop. That is amazing.
I thought you'd like it, eh? How cool is that? An electric Maserati BiTurbo. All you need to do is throw some batteries in, get them on charge, whoosh, straight out the door.
No, mate, we can do so much better than that. If we put in a really sporty motor and a sporty set of batteries, we will have an awesome, awesome vehicle. I mean, it'd be absolutely incredible. Right now, classic cars converted to electric are so current.
I see what you've done there. I know that. I know the market for electric cars is kind of popular at the moment. Where are you going?
Open the boot.
Why do you need... Look, Ed, seriously. It's too much money. What you're talking about is too complicated. As I say, all we need to do is to put the batteries in it.
We've got to do it right.
OK, well, I'll investigate the market. Just don't spend too much.
No, no, it'll be great. It'll be great. Fine. Thanks, mate. No, it was a good job.
Oh, thanks a lot. Yeah, thanks, Mike. Cheers, Mike. Thanks for getting me a nice gift. I really appreciate it.
So the guys at EV West have given me some incredible insight as to where we can take our Maserati, because after all, we did start with something rather agricultural. This brushed DC motor can only manage about 100 foot-pounds of torque, about 50 horsepower. But the real disadvantage is the fact that you have to change the brushes about every 2,000 miles or so. Not good. Which is why we're going to go with a brushless AC induction motor. Now, this thing can produce about 120 foot-pounds of torque and about 71 horsepower. So we're already on to a winner. But of course, our car is a bi-turbo. So why not fit two motors? So we now have 142 horsepower, which is only slightly less than the car would have come out of the factory when it had a petrol engine. But we do actually have 240 foot-pounds of torque, which is 50 more. And all that torque is available right from zero revs, so the acceleration is going to be incredible. Before we can drop our new power plant into the engine bay, I need to attach motor controllers and the clutch pack. These motor controllers can be thought of as the electrical equivalent to a carburetor. They determine how much electricity goes into the motor, controlling the motor speed. Now, another advantage of going for two smaller motors rather than one big one is you can then run two smaller motor controllers. Now, these do cost about $2,000 each, and they can handle about 650 amps, which is actually quite chunky, to be fair. But a 1,300-amp controller would cost about $8,000, so it really is quite a saving. And, of course, the same goes for all of the other parts or components that are going to be used, including little switches, fuses, all that kind of stuff, all the cabling even, is all going to be way more expensive for much higher current. So this really is a very clever, economical way to go. Right, we now have two motor controllers in place, one each for each of the motors in this common housing. And of course, they also share a common shaft. So I spin this end, you can see this end moving. And the idea is they should work in harmony with any luck. Now, before I explain how the controllers work, I should really explain how an electric motor works. Principally, it relies heavily on the magical forces of magnetism. So I'm just going to get myself a rare earth magnet. This is neodymium. This is super strong, super magnetic. I'm just going to put a screw onto the top of our magnet. This works as a bearing, as also electrical connection. I then put a battery there, like so. It's just a standard AA battery, 1.5 volts. Now, when I run current through the wire, it actually creates magnetic force. And there's a little rule you can use. So if the current's going that way, I can actually see the lines of force are going to be going in a kind of a rotation. So if I now connect up the wire to connect the circuit and therefore get our magnetic fields going, you can see that the magnet actually decides to take the path of least resistance because the wire can't go anywhere, and it starts to spin. And there you have it. You have one of the easiest or simplest electric motors. Threading the splines on the first motion shaft into those in the clutch plate can mean a little fiddling is required. Our twin Curtis AC induction motors cost us approximately $4,000, $2,000 a motor, the third most expensive component in our renewed EV system. But a bargain, really. I've just been doing some calculations to try and work out what size battery pack we should put in our electrified Maserati. Now, it's all going to come down to energy density. Now, when the car came out of the factory, it was running on gasoline, and gasoline is incredibly energy dense. You actually get about 13,000 watt-hours per every kilogram of gasoline. So when you think about our petrol-based Maserati, it used to manage about 14 miles to the gallon. So 2 gallons of gas will get it about 28 miles. Whereas a 3 kilowatt-hour battery pack, nearly the same kind of volume in size, was actually going to get you about maybe 10 miles of range with our electric version. Now, I've done some measuring and I've worked out I can get about 12 of these battery packs into the boot of our Maserati, and that'll give us a range of about 120 miles. Now, that is considerably less than we would have got from a full tank of gas, but those 120 miles are only going to cost us about $4 in electricity, as opposed to the gasoline, which would cost us about 6 times that at $25. And bear in mind, our new electrified Maserati will be about 100 times as reliable and about 100 times as fun.
Big money savings, but of course, we're also doing our bit to save the planet.
Right, so we now have our 120-volt DC battery pack installed in the boot of our car, but there is one more battery which is actually still very important, the original 12-volt accessory battery. Now, obviously, it's designed to run all the 12-volt systems of the car, including things like headlights, windscreen wipers. Perhaps its most important job is to energize the contactors, the big relays that connect the battery pack to the motor controllers, because without that, we couldn't turn our EV on or off. Now, a great thing about all this being electronic is it's all programmable via this device here. I can set all kinds of things like the throttle response, the severity of the regen braking, even the top speed of the motor. All very cool.
The car or cruise cost me $2,740. The entire EV conversion, a massive $16,764. Wheels and tyres, $971. Dent repair and respray, $1,474. And refreshing the interior, $112. This gives us a grand total of $22,481. That's around £15,000 and 57 man hours. That affordable piece of Italian luxury isn't quite affordable now.
Oh, I like it. Oh, it's so strange, isn't it? Very, very quiet. You know, you get that little noise coming from the tyres and the reassuring zing coming from the motor, but really refined, very nice.
It's amazing. I mean, driving an electrified classic car is so the way forward. It's such a different and exciting experience. The clutch, you don't actually need to use the clutch. Obviously, it will pull away right from zero RPM. So, of course, you only really need to change gear, but actually, I'm driving around in third.
I see there's some other little additions inside our cockpit.
So the first gauge actually lets us know how much energy we've got left in our 36 kilowatt hour battery pack. And then the other two dials are actually connected to each of the motor controllers. And the idea is there you can see what kind of current you're using, all that kind of stuff.
So 36 kilowatt hours, yeah. What does that mean in terms of miles?
About 120 miles range.
That's not bad, is it? How does it drive?
When the Maserati first came out of the factory, it managed about 180 horsepower, about 188 foot-pounds of torque. But now, this little chap is managing 150 horsepower, but 212 foot-pounds of torque.
Oh, that sounds a bit disappointing. So it's down on power?
Well, ever so slightly. But actually, the thing about it is, of course, when you think about a petrol engine, obviously you have to get up into a power band, and then you obviously get through that power band, have to change gear, and then go again. Whereas with this, you have maximum power right from the very first RPM.
Whoa! Is that for real?
Absolutely.
Do it again. Whoa! And that's in third gear.
That's in third gear.
Whoa, this car. Oh, God, I can feel this car's going to be rapido, isn't it?
Click here to subscribe.